Hello, Didier Stevens here from the Internet Storm Center. We are going to look at the new Yara. So the Yara I have here is 4.0.2, and with version 4, B64 rules were introduced. So that means that you can provide a string in a Yara rule, and then that the B64 encodings of that string will be searched for. So I have a rule here that looks for Internet Storm Center, and this has to be B64 encoded. And I have this in this example. So this here is B64 for Internet Storm Center. I can show you this with my toolkit bytes. B64. And the string Internet Storm Center. See, encoded gives this string. Of course, this varies depending on the character position. If I insert a space before Internet Storm Center, then I have another B64 string. One more space, yet another string, and three spaces. And then here I have four different characters and then repeating string here. That's because in base64, 8 bits, 1 byte, 8 bits are encoded into 6 bits, one base64 character. So that means that you need 4 base64 digits, characters, for 3 bytes. So that's what the encoder here does, the base64 encoder in Yara. So I run Yara with the rule on base64 here, and my rule detects it. Now you can also have different combinations depending on your strings being ASCII or Unicode. I have here different other rules, a long list, so each time Internet Storm Center, and here this rule, I expect that the string to be encoded is ASCII, then it then is in base64 encoded, and that base64 encoded string is also ASCII. While this rule here, the string to be searched for, the encoded string to be searched for, is a Unicode string, and it is encoded in base64, and that base64 string itself is ASCII. Another rule here, again, an ASCII string to be encoded. And now the base64 string that I'm searching for has to be Unicode. That's done with the keyword base64 white. So instead of base64, use base64 white. And finally, Unicode. Unicode, so I have a string that is Unicode, so white. And the base64 string representation of that string is also has to be Unicode, so base64 white. And finally, I have a rule that implements all searches, so ASCII and Unicode for the string to be encoded, and then base64 and base64 white for the encodings. And if I run Yara with those rules here, then I have those different files that I prepared that are detected, like the file ASCII. If we look at an hexadecimal dump, an ASCII hexadecimal dump of this file, sorry, like this, you can see that it is ASCII. Here I have the Unicode base64 string, and if we look at this with my tool, you can see here that it is Unicode, and you have a lot of null bytes. And then if we look at the Unicode string that is base64 encoded into an ASCII string, then you have another representation. As you can see, a lot of A's. And that is because A, the uppercase A character in base64 encodes 6 bits with value 0. Here you can see that it is ASCII. And finally, the Unicode into Unicode. Here, as you can see, this is Unicode.